Hi students, knowing our numbers is our first chapter. We have already learnt comparing numbers, using of commas, ascending order, descending order, and then 1,10,000, larger numbers, and how to write, how to use of commas in Indian system and international system also. We have learnt and we have done the exercise 1.1 also. Now, exercise 1.2. Large numbers in practice. We have already learnt about how we use of centimeter as a unit of length. For measuring length of pencil, the width of the book, our notebooks, our table, like that, we will use centimeters. Our ruler as marks each on each centimeter. For measuring of thickness of a pencil, however, we find centimeter is too big, so we will use millimeter. So that means we already learned this, 10 millimeter equal to 1 centimeter. To measure the length of the classroom, any rooms, school buildings, like that, we will use meters. Centimeter is too small for that, so we will use meters for that. So 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. We already know this. 10 millimeter equal to 1 centimeter. So 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter means we have to replace the 100 into 10. So 1 meter equal to 1,000 millimeters. Got it? Okay. Now, for the distance between the cities or any two places, we will calculate using kilometers. We will mention that kilometers because meter is too small for that. So 1 kilometer equal to how many meters? 1,000 meters. Now I'll ask one question. How many millimeters will make 1 kilometer? Yes, 1 meter equal to, we know, 1000 millimeter. 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. So we have to replace that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 into 1000 millimeter. So what is the answer? 10 lakh millimeter. Got it? Now for weighing purpose, that means we will go to the market to buy rice or wheat. We'll buy it in kilograms. But items like small quantities like ginger, chilies, that and all, we need not to buy in large quantities. We will buy in small quantities. That, for that, we will use grams. Here, we have already know that 1 kilogram equal to 1000 grams. 1 gram equal to 1000 milligrams. For capacity, what will you use? Liter and milliliters. 1 liter equal to how many milliliters? 1000 milliliters. Milli means smallest value. Kilo is the greatest value. Clear? For this purpose, centi shows 100 times smaller, that is 1 meter equal to 100 centimeters. So centi means 100 times smaller. Clear? Metric units of length, 10 millimeter equal to 1 centimeter, 10 centimeter equal to 1 decimeter, 10 decimeter equal to 1 meter, 10 meter equal to 1 decameter, 10 decameter equal to 1 hectometer, 10 hectometer equal to 1 kilometer. You have already learned about millimeter, centimeter, like this, na? And decimeter, decameter, hectometer and all, rarely we will use it. From the above slide, you can answer it now. How much millimeters make 1 centimeter? Let's answer. 10 millimeter make 1 centimeter. How many centimeters make 1 meter? 100 centimeter equal to 1 meter. How many meters will make 1 kilometer? 1000 meters will make 1 kilometer. Next question. How many millimeters will make 1 kilometer? We already know that 1 kilometer equal to 1,000 meter. So 1,000 meter equal to 1 meter equal to 1,000 millimeter. So we have to multiply 1,000 into 1,000. So 1 kilometer equal to 1,000 into 1,000. That equal to 10 lakh millimeter. Got it? Example 1. Population of Sundar Nahar was 2,35,471 in the year 1991. In the year 2001, it was found to be increased by 72,958. What was the population of the city in 2001? Population of Sundar Nahar is 2,35,471 in the year 1991. And then they given the increasing value. Now we have to add these two numbers, 2,35,471 plus 72,958. When we are adding these two numbers, we will get the answer 3,08,429. Therefore, the population of the city in 2001 is 3,08,429. Example 2. In one state, the number of bicycles sold in the year 2002 to 2003 was 7,43,000. In the year 2003 to 2004, the number of bicycles sold was 8,00,000. In which year were more bicycles sold and how many more? So in this, they given year-wise how many bicycles sold. Okay, now what we have to find? How many more bicycles? So we have to subtract these two numbers. 8,00,000 minus 7,43,000. So subtract it and you have to find the answer. Okay. Try it yourself. I'll tell the answer now. The answer is 57,100. Check the answer by adding the answer. You can get the answer if it is right or not. Now find it. 7,43,000. Plus 57,100. If you are adding together, we will get the answer 8,00,000. So our answer is correct. Example 3. The town newspaper is published every day. One copy has 12 pages. Every day 11,900 copies are printed. How many total pages are printed every day? Each copy has 12 pages, isn't it? One copy has 12 pages, then 11,980 copies will be 11,980 into 12. So what is the answer? Multiply these two numbers from two table. First you have to multiply 23,960. You can get now again one tens place now. So you have to place one number. So 11,980, add the numbers. So 1,43,760, you will get the answer. Therefore, every day 1,43,760 pages are printed. Example 4. The number of sheets of paper available for making notebooks is 75,000. So number of sheets, 75,000 they given. Each sheet makes 8 pages of a notebook. Okay. Each notebook contains 200 pages. How many notebooks can be made from the paper available? So here we have to do two operations. First one is multiplication and then second one is division. First we have to make the multiplication because one sheet makes 8 pages. 75,000 sheets make how many pages? So we have to multiply 75,000 into 8. What is the answer you will get? 6 lakh pages. Okay. Now 6 lakh pages are available for making notebooks. One notebook have how many pages? 200 pages. Here 6 lakh pages are there. We have to make how many notebooks we are going to find now. Okay. Now 6 lakh divided by 200. What is the answer? 6 divided by 2? 3. Isn't it 2 table? So now You are getting the answer 3000. How many notebooks you will get? 3000 notebooks you will get. Got it? Are you clear with these examples? Shall we go to exercise 1.2? Question number 1. A book exhibition was held for 4 days in a school. A number of tickets sold at the counter on the first, second, third, and final day was respectively. Were they given? 1,094, 1,812, 2,050, 2,751. They given. Find the total number of tickets sold on all the 4 days. Total number of tickets we need means we have to sum up all the values. Add all the values and tell the answer. What is the answer you will get? 1,094 plus 1,812 plus 2,050 plus 2,751. What is the answer? 7,707. So therefore, the tickets, 7,707 tickets were sold on all the 4 days. Question number 2. Shekhar is a famous cricket player. He has so far scored 6,980 runs in test matches. He wishes to complete 10,000 runs. How many more runs does he need? So how many more runs they are asking? So we have to subtract. Then only we can find how many more runs. So runs to achieve 10,000. Runs scored. How much he has scored? 6,980. Runs required 3,020. If you subtract, you can get the answer. Your 10,000, you have to subtract 6,980 now. So you have to take borrow from 10. Then only you can get the answer. So therefore, he needs 3,020 more runs. Clear? Next question. Question number 3. In an election, the successful candidate registered 5,77,500 votes and his nearest rival secured 3,48,700 votes. By what margin did the successful candidate win the election? So by what margin they are asking? So what we have to do here, also we have to subtract that. 5,77,500 subtract 3,48,700. What will you answer? You will get margin 2,28,800. Question number 4. Kirti Bookstore sold books worth 2,85,891 in the first week of June and books worth 4,768 in the second week of the month. How much was the sale for the 2 weeks together? In which week was the sale greater and by how much they are asking? So first 2 weeks together means we have to add both the values. 2,85,891 plus 4,768. So which is a greater value here? So we have to find the total first. What is the answer? 6,86,659, you will get the answer, total books sold. Now compare that first week of June and second week of month. What is the answer? 4,768 is greater than 2,85,891. So how much are they asking? Isn't it? How much greater? So for that we have to subtract from the second week. Which is a greater one that? 4,768 subtract 2,85,891. What will be the answer you will get? You try yourself. I'll tell the answer now. 1,14,877. More books were sold in the second week. Got it? Question number 5. Find the difference between the greatest and the least number that can be written using the digits 6, 2, 7, 4, 3, each only once. We have already learnt how to make three digit number, greatest three digit number, smallest three digit number, greatest four digit, like that. Now we are going to do five digit number. How will you do that? For greatest five digit number, we have to write in descending order. For smallest five digit number, we have to write in ascending order. Now arrange the numbers in descending order. Which is a greater number there? 7. Next number 6. Next 4. Next number 3. And then next 2. So what is the greatest 5 digit number using these digits? 76,432. Now smallest 5 digit number using these digits. Reverse the above said number. So what is it? 23,467. That is ascending order of the given numbers. Okay, now find out the difference. What is the difference between these two numbers? Can you find the difference? You have to subtract and tell the answer. Okay, shall we go to the next question? Question number 6. A machine on average manufactures 2,825 screws a day. How many screws did it produce in the month of January 2006? Number of screws manufactured in one day is 2,825. Number of days in the month of January. How many days in January? 31 days. So 2,825 into 31 we are going to do. Multiply and tell the answer. 87,575. Therefore, the machine produced 87,575 screws in the month of January. Clear? Question number 7. A merchant had 78,592 with her. She placed an order for purchasing 40 radio sets at 1,200 each. How much money will remain with her after the purchase? Here we have to do the two operations, because one radio 1,200, 40 radio set, we have to multiply 40 into 1,200. 12 fours are 48. So how many zeros we have to add? 3 zeros. So answer is 48,000. Now total money with merchant, how much money she has? 78,592. She spent 48,000. So how much left with her? Left means we have to subtract. So 78,592 subtract 30,592, you can get the answer. Therefore 30,592 will remain with her after the purchase. Got it? Now case number 8. A student multiplied 7,236 by 65 instead of multiplying by 56. Got it now? Instead of 56, yes, multiplied by 65. By how much was his answer greater than the correct answer? So what we have to do first? We have to multiply both the numbers 65 and 56, and we have to subtract from the numbers. First multiply 7,236 into 65. You can get the answer 4,70,340. Now multiply the next number 7,236 into 56. So the number is 5,216. Now difference. Subtract these two numbers. You can get the answer 65,124. Try yourself, you can get the answer properly. Question number 9. To stitch a shirt 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 40 meter cloth, how many shirts can be stretched and how much cloth will remain, they are asking. That means you have to divide the 40 meter by 2 meter 15 centimeter. For this, first convert this into same units. Okay, so for 40 meter convert, you can get the answer 4000 centimeter. Now 2 meter 15 centimeter, for this you have to convert 2 meter, so that means 200 centimeter plus 15 centimeter, you will get the answer 215 centimeter. Now 4000 divided by 215. Division procedure we have to do. First 4000, from that we have to take 400 na 3 digit number. So how many 215 we can place there? Only 1. So 1215 equal to 215. Now subtract 400 minus 215. You can get the answer 185. Now take down the number 0. So you will get 1850. Now multiply the number 18 to 215. You can get the answer 1720. Now again subtract. So you will get the answer 130. Again we cannot do that because 215 is greater than the 130. Isn't it? So 130 is the remaining part. So 18 shirts can be stitched and 130 centimeter, that means 1 meter 30 centimeter cloth will be remain. Got it? Question number 10. Medicine is packed in boxes, each weighing 4 kilogram 500 gram. How many such boxes can be loaded in a van which cannot carry beyond 800 kilogram? Okay, what are they giving? One box weighing 4 kilogram 500 gram. That van cannot carry beyond 800 kilogram. That should be below 800 kilogram only. Okay. For that, how many boxes they are asking? So for this, we have to convert the units in same. 4 kilogram 500 gram. How will you convert in gram? 4 into 1000 plus 500. So 4000 plus 500. Answer is 4500 gram. Okay. Now 800 kilogram. How will you convert in gram? 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. So we have to multiply by 1000. 800 into 1000, we can get the answer 8 lakh gram. Okay, now divide 8 lakh by, divided by 4500. Okay, 8 lakh divided by 4500, you can get the answer 177. Therefore, 177 boxes can be loaded. Question number 11. The distance between the school and the house of a student's house is 1 kilometer 875 meter. Every day she walks both ways. Find the total distance be covered by her in 6 days. So that means she walks to the school, to the house 1 kilometer 875 meter. Again she walks back same 1 kilometer 875 meter. So total distance means we have to add these both values, isn't it? First add the values. For that we will convert this into decimal values. 1.875 kilometer, and then distance between home and school is 1.875 kilometer. Now add the these values. 3.750 kilometer. Okay, this is for one day. They are asking for 6 days. Distance covered in 6 days means we have to multiply the both numbers. 3.750 into 6. So we will get 22.500. That means 20 kilometer 500 meter distance covered in 6 days. Now last question of this exercise. Question number 12. A vessel has 4 liters and 500 ml of curd. In how many glasses each of 25 milliliter capacity can it be filled? Capacity of a curd in a vessel. That means 4 liter 500 ml. So now convert this. 1 liter equal to 1000 ml. So we will multiply that. 4 into 1000. So 4000 ml plus 500 ml. We can get the answer 4500 ml. Capacity of 1 glass. That is 25 ml. So number of glasses can be filled means 4500 divided by 25. Can you divide this number? You can get the answer 180. Therefore 180 glasses can be filled by curd. Thank you. All the best.